You have leads coming in through Facebook ads. They're going in there and you're having to check them manually. So you're wondering, how the heck can I get them to my CRM? Watch this video. I'm going to show you how that's possible. Hey everyone, thank you so much for being here. Really do appreciate it. For more tips on how you can use technology to grow your real estate business, then please, you know the drill. Hit the subscribe button and click the bell to be notified of when I post a new video every single Wednesday. I myself teach a course to realtors showing them how they can get leads just through the power of Facebook ads. And one of the biggest questions in that course, how do I get them to go to my CRM automatically? Well, I'm going to cover that in this video and show you my screen here right away and take you step by step how you can do that. First thing you're going to want to do is navigate over to your Facebook. Go to your Facebook business page. Of course, as you know, you need to have a Facebook business page to run ads. So go to your business page. At the top, you're going to notice a few different options. And some of you may see it right here. It may say publishing tools. For others like mine, it just may say more. So click on more and then you can click on publishing tools. Once you are within publishing tools, on the left-hand side, you're going to see a few different options. Down here at leads ad form, you're going to want to click on lead setup. Now, here's where you can connect to your CRM. So first thing you want to do is search the CRM that you're using. Now, as some of you may know from past videos and everything, I use RealVolve. So I'm going to search RealVolve and click on it. So it says it can connect and it says it's connecting through LeadsBridge. Now, one thing is it looks like, oh, this is going to be simple. I'll just connect it. LeadsBridge is a paid program. So it may do it at the start, but eventually you are going to have to pay for it and will be charged for it. So in the next part of this video, I'm going to explain to you a couple different websites you can actually go to that may end up being free or end up costing you less money than what it would be on Facebook. But basically from there, you could connect it and then it's going to take you through the whole process here. So saying you want to connect your leads with RealVolve. And then you can just go through this. It'll take you through the whole process of getting it connected and having it so your leads on your business page end up going into your CRM. So just go through that whole process. It'll walk you through it all. Now I'm not going to set it up here on mine just because I don't want to use this LeadsBridge because I've got mine set up a different way, but that just gives you a good idea where you need to go in the back end to get it set up. Now in the next part of this video, like I said, I'm going to show you a couple other options you could do, and just to give you a quick rundown of how that works, the one I'm going to speak about is Zapier. So it's going to say connect this app. What do you want to connect? So this is where I search for Facebook lead ads, click on there, and it says where do you want to send it to. Again, mine's RealVolve, and you may want to search, and like I said, in the next part I'm going to talk about another website called API Nation just in case this one doesn't work, but RealVolve. And then same thing, it takes you through the whole process of what you need to do. So you can hit try this. And the great thing with Zapier is it walks you through everything step by step, exactly what you need to do. This is paid with this one, with RealVolve. You do have to pay for it, but there is some CRMs where it will not cost you anything. So it says, which website do you want, or which Facebook page do you want to connect this with? I can say that it's mine. Then it says, which RealVolve account do you want to connect it to? So right now it's showing mine in there because I've already done it, but you're going to have to connect with your CRM because it wants your login and everything, so it knows which one. And then it probably will walk you through some more steps. I clicked on go to advanced mode because it's not showing up, but again, I don't need to connect this because I've already done it. But basically it's going to say choose an app, which is Facebook lead ads. What do you want us to do? Well, I want you to do something when I get a new lead. Perfect. Go continue. Choose account. Which account? I want to use Shawn Bell's. Continue. There's my page and it says, what form do you want to use? So if you've been watching my prior videos, if not, go here and I show you step by step how you can create an effective Facebook ad. And on that one, I talk about creating a form. So you can actually create a form and you can just specify here in Zapier saying, I just want, anytime somebody fills out this form, I want it sent to RealVolve. Or all I'm doing is ads and it's always doing lead generation. I'm gonna have it go into the exact same process in my CRM. I'm gonna click any form, so all of them. So you could do either or. Then you go continue, and then it'll get you to do a test just to seeing if it can find any data. I'm gonna skip that right now because I'm not gonna set this one up. But then it says, okay, now that we get the lead, what do you want to do when it's in your CRM? So then here I'm saying, okay, I want to select RealVolve because that's my app. What's the event? I want to create a new contact within RealVolve. What account do you want? You'll have to select that. Mine's already selected. Then it's going to say what fields do you want to match up with your Facebook. So remember, when you're creating a form in Facebook on your ad, you're telling it to collect or have them input their name, their email, and their phone number. So it's going to ask you in here, based off the form or any of them, what are those, which fields in Facebook are you wanting to transfer over into your CRM? So you could say, I want their full name, because we're asking for the name. I want a phone number to go over, and I want email. The rest you don't really have to worry about, because Facebook is not going to collect those. So that way it's telling your CRM, these are the fields. When they come in, these three fields, this is what I want you to label them as. I want you to label them as name, email, and number. Then you can choose your source. So for this is just a Facebook or a RealVolve thing, just saying if we put this contact in your CRM or in the CRM, where do you want us to tell you it came from? So this is great for lead tracking. So anytime I'm in my RealVolve and I have somebody with the tag Facebook, I know they came through an ad. And then I don't really need to go through this because this is more about RealVolve, and you may not use RealVolve, so this will just confuse the heck out of you. But basically, I'm just telling it now, when that lead comes into RealVolve, what do I want RealVolve to do with that lead? And if any of you know about RealVolve, I have certain workflows set up. So it's telling it, put this contact in RealVolve and put them in this workflow. And the workflow I have set up is for leads. So when that lead comes in, they automatically get set up on that workflow, and it automatically sends them emails for the next 10 days. So it's really, like I said, I run a course, or I teach this to realtors, and my course is called Facebook Leads on Autopilot. And that's exactly what we focus on here, is because the leads are coming in and everything is taken care of for you, and it's all happening on autopilot, so you don't have to worry about it. So just maybe something you want to think about on your CRM and you have to get set up. But when you get it set up here, like through Zapier, as you can see, there's so many options here you can tell it to do, saying when that lead comes in and we push it to RealVolve, from there, what the heck do you want to happen in RealVolve? Zapier takes care of all that. So like I said, keep watching this video. I'm going to show you a couple different websites you can go to, and what you're going to want to do in order to get it figured out to know which is the best way for you to go. How many leads do you average per ad that you run on Facebook? Comment below and let me know. So from the example I showed you, that's hooking it up through Facebook. Now you can take that a step further and you can find some different sites that maybe do this for you. Now Facebook generally will kind of have their recommendation if you can find your CRM there. Like I explained, if you can't, you may have to go alternative routes. Just because you can't find it in Facebook does not mean that it isn't there and it is not possible. So don't give up. If you can't find it in that Facebook search, there's probably still a good chance you can get it hooked up. There's a couple sites I do recommend. One is Zapier.com, and the other one is API Nation. Now, I've looked at both and I strongly recommend you do the same. But take a look at their pricing and the different features that they have, because depending on the type of CRM you're using is going to be the difference of which one of those programs that you want to use. I right now use Zapier for mine. I have mine hooked up through RealVolve. RealVolve is the CRM I use. If you want more information on RealVolve, got you covered. Click on that link there. I do a tutorial about basically different CRMs and why I love RealVolve so much. But like I said, I have RealVolve, and the best way for me to connect it with Facebook was through Zapier. When I originally went to connect it through Facebook, it wanted me to connect it through their own platform of Leads Bridge. Basically, it was end up going to cost me more than would it be through Zapier. Zapier does the exact same thing, so check that out. And then if depending on the price of Zapier, then go check out API Nation, because it could be cheaper, it could be more expensive. For RealVolve, it was more expensive. But I have seen other CRMs where API Nation is actually cheaper than Zapier. So make sure you do check out both of those, as well as the Facebook. They have the built-in feature as well. Find out which one's gonna work the best for you. Some of them are actually free. I know lots of you guys use KV Core. And if I remember correctly, through Zapier, or through the Facebook one itself. I don't remember 100%, don't quote me, but one of those was no extra cost. So bonus to you, you don't even have to pay to use them. So like I said, go check it out, get it hooked up, and you're gonna have those leads coming into your CRM now, which is gonna be amazing, because before then you had to check it manually, you couldn't get back to them right away. But now that it's hooked up to your CRM, you'll get a notification if it's hooked up in your CRM correctly to notify you. Get out back to that lead immediately, nurture them, land them, and close them. That's the whole point of this. So now that you know exactly how to hook up Facebook ads to your CRM, but you're wanting maybe some more information on how to set up an effective Facebook ad, then you're gonna wanna click on the link in my description below. In there, I have my free guide. I call it my Facebook Lead Ad Checklist. It's gonna take you step by step on how to effectively set up a converting ad to get leads. And always, when you're done here, don't forget to check out my prior videos that I did on Facebook ads. And please, guys, if this was beneficial, like, comment, hit the subscribe button. Really helps me out, and share with anyone else this may be beneficial for.